Good evening, everyone. I'm Takahiro Sato from Advanced Cable Systems in Japan. Today, I will talk about introduction of visual connection identifier for optical line. We call VCI. So let me start. This slide shows I have 8 items on my agenda. Showing this slide, I will explain the background of developing this technology, problem of current technology, merit of our technology, and finally, I will explain next generation product concept. Then I will describe the structure of our system, how it is operated, and benefits. These benefits include timely warnings of breakdowns, accurate and effective use of terminals, and flexible use of human resources. Next, I'd like to explain the present conditions of the internet communications of Japan. Net surf and e-commerce mainstream of the internet communication in Japan until 7 years ago. However, SNS, net gaming and on-demand movie becomes popular. Becomes the mobile device such as a smartphone or the tablet PC have been developed the multi-function mobile device. Next, I'd like to provide the change every year the internet traffic in Japan. The graph shows the internet traffic flows in Japan. Internet traffic increases at speed of plus 50 per year because of the spread of smartphone and tablet PC. Japan expects that the internet traffic keep increasing at the pace in future. Next, I'd like to explain the utilization of a data center network in Japan. Data management of net banking and transaction for main user, but not Net gaming and on-demand movie providers become main users and they provide cloud service. Please take a look at this picture. It shows a cabinet in NTT Communications office in Tokyo. NTT Communication is a long distance carrier and data center operator worldwide. They have begun to pre-install a high fiber count optical cable between floors and also set up IDM cabinets each floor. To provide quick and efficient service to the colocation service by decreasing installation time. IDM cabinets contain several critical transmission lines, such as high-speed internet connections and other services. As you can see, we have to restore and eliminate system downtime after broken down or disaster. A our mission is to speed up restoration. Here is a short movie on how we find out the broken down section. Qualified person rush to the location. They check the wiring diagram and remove the connector at the cable connection point. This process is done at every connection point until the broken down section has been located. As you can see, this slide shows the problem of the data center network. This entire process of restoration is very time consuming. First, we needed to identify the broken down section. Then we need to identify the broken down transmission line. At the same time, we need to avoid possible complications caused by human error. These are two types of human error we expect. First, the wiring diagram or TAN may be described incorrectly. Second, the engineer may not have checked the connector or cable marking correctly. Why does this process take so long? Yes. So, the solution is to reduce the time needed. We need to visually identify the live line to confirm the status of the transmission line. The new system must meet these five requirements. First, visually identify the live line. Number two, be confirm near connection point. Third, be detected regardless of fiber type. Number four, be detected without loss chain. And five, require no power supply. Please look at this picture. This device is used to grasp a line to check whether it is live or not. But the pressure varies with the person's strength, which is kind of the sheet of the person's pants. Also, there is another reason why this method cannot be used. That is, made resistant fiber is getting popular these days. which will not be live right. This picture is detailed structure of our product and NTT Communications adapt this method. The light source goes through the OPD and a little escape light is caught by the photodiode. It is then amplified and lights up the LED. This picture is use of our products and NTT Communications adapt this method. We have pull out of the connector from optical distinction module. The module can detect leakage light from each connector independently. You can visually to know the transmission status of the detective module. Our system shows which line is live by using two color LEDs. Blue light when the transmission line is live. Red light when the transmission line is not live. Here is a short movie of the installation. You can locate the broken down section very easily and quickly. As a first effect, 30% faster to identify by broken down section. As a second effect, as you can see, blue light equal live light, red light equal not live light. No human error and no mistake. As a next effect, EV port that is not being used is a waste. The unused port will later be disconnected or used efficiently. I'd like to explain the new technology structure. The structure of the developed optical connector. This connector type, this connector is an SG type adapter that consists of peril holder, housing, wall cover, and sleeve. The fiber in the peril are the beams cut by the micron slit. This micron slit. The ferrule holder maintains the slit position. The hole set to correct position for PD and avoid external light. The hole cover avoids dust. The sales result of this connector are 50,000 volts. which I like to provide the structure of the optical distinction module. This module consists of PD, LED, LED, battery switch, and sending guide. The PD detects the leakage light in transmission line. Two LEDs show the distinction result. The blue LED on when the transmission is red line. The red LED on when there is no transmission is employed. This module is driven 3-volt button battery. The switch is used for power saving. Sending guide protects the PD and set to correct position for the connector. This size is width 36 mm, height 45 mm, depth 45 mm. Target is easy operation. Next, I'd like to explain the design of the detecting sensitivity. This detection sensitivity is decided by amount of the leakage light from the slit in the connector to failure. Number two, the size of the PD chip. Number three, position of the connector to failure and the PD. Number one, the width of slit was decided targeting at the connector insertion loss 1 dB or less. The size of chip was designed to identify light intensity above minus 30 dBm. AD shows the sensitivity measurement result. Displacement in the direction of X, Y, and Z. X displacement shows the distance of the vertical direction against vector axis. Y displacement shows the distance of optical axis direction. And Z displacement shows the distance of the between failure and PD. The result shows that the displacement along Z axis affects the sensitivity drastically. Hence, to obtain good sensitivity, the PD should be positioned as close as possible to the pipe. To achieve this, wedge is formed on the failure, so as to locate PD close to the center part of the failure. PD was brought close to the fiber as much as possible. Next, I'd like to explain the new technology structure. This connector is LC type. That consists of Peru holder, housing, hole cover, and slit. The Peru holder maintains the slit position. The hole set to correct position for PD and avoid external light. The hole cover avoids dust. We release this product in April. The new dual connection identifier operation system will be announced soon. And a function to read port identification address in UCI itself. operator performs remote monitoring. Trouble discovery becomes early even at the time of a disaster early and early restoration becomes possible. We develop a new transmission line distinction technology. As a result, the operating time to the recovery is increased by minus 30%. In addition, the biggest concern for this operation was complicated termination. This technology can use a connector for effective utilization is enabled with facilities. This technology relies flexibility of human resource. Thank you for your kind attention. That's all.
Did you say 1 dB loss at the slit? Can we afford, what if we have three of those in the line? That'd be 3 dB loss? Does it ever break at the slit? Does it break?
Actually, fine cut. Not a break, but fine cut. So that the leakage light will be produced. And regarding the loss, 1 dB is the worst case, but average is 0.7 dB in case of SC connector. But in case of LC, with new technology, average loss is around 0.5 again. But in case of LC type connector, the loss depends on type of signal. Because in case of LD signal, loss is less than 0.5. But our figure shows the worst case.
How deep is that?